Hello, anatomists. Michele Glass here, and our job for today is to look at structures of the endocrine system. Now, this video will be looking at models, and then we will have a second video on diagrams. Remember, the endocrine system is a system that produces hormones, so this is long-term communication, and we'll talk more about what hormones each gland produces in that second video. So for this one, we're just finding these structures on the model. And I have several different models for us to look at today. And I want to start with one that does just sort of like an overview of some of the different glands of the endocrine system. So let's take a look here. So we actually are going to start in the brain. We have three endocrine glands that are located in the brain. And I can't show them very easily on this particular model, so I'll show you those on the brain model itself. And on this model here, what we can really see is the pituitary gland. So we can see that highlighted in this block right here. Moving down into the neck region, we're going to see the thyroid gland. Okay, so we can see it right here. And then actually on the posterior view of the thyroid, we have four parathyroid glands. So we're looking at the back side of the thyroid to pick out the four parathyroid glands. As we moved into the abdominopelvic region, we can see kidneys, and sitting on top of the kidneys, you have the gland called the adrenal gland. So that's what we can see right here. And then we also can see in the abdominopelvic region, the pancreas. And we're seeing those cells in that tissue highlighted more here, but I'm going to show you that more on the diagrams. I think it's a little bit easier to tell on the diagram. Now, these glands that we've pointed out so far would be considered primary endocrine system glands, meaning, you know, it's their first job to make hormones. We also have what are described as secondary endocrine glands. And these are structures that make hormones, but that's not their first and foremost job. An example of secondary endocrine glands includes gonads. So we see gonads represented down here. These are going to be in the pelvic cavity. So we have a different set of gonads depending on if you're in a female body with ovaries or a male body with testes. And so over here we see the testis, that's the singular form of the word, and over here we see the ovary. Now we do think about these gonads as being responsible for a lot of the sex hormones that are regulating the reproductive system, and also responsible for development of what we call secondary sex characteristics. But first and foremost, the job of the gonad is to make what we call sex cells. So that would be either the egg cell from the ovary or the sperm cell from the testes. Okay, this model here also does a nice overview of the endocrine system. I actually like it better than what we just looked at. So let's take a look here. And again, we're seeing a lot of primary endocrine structures, and we'll start with those. And then we are seeing the secondary endocrine structures of the gonads represented here as well. So this is actually looking in the brain, and we're seeing in this tissue right here, this is what's called the hypothalamus. And again, I'll show that to you in the brain context in just a little bit. And then we're seeing here what's called the pituitary gland. Now, there are several structures to label with the pituitary gland. So the first would be this tissue here that's attaching pituitary to hypothalamus. And this tissue right here is called the infundibulum. We will see also that the pituitary gland is divided into an anterior lobe and posterior lobe. So here we can see anterior lobe different from posterior because the neurons from the hypothalamus extend into the posterior lobe. Now we have another name for the pituitary gland. It's called the hypophysis. So we can actually call the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland the adenohypophysis. And then we can refer to the posterior lobe as the neurohypophysis. So we see hypothalamus, we see the connecting tissue called infundibulum, and we see both the adenohypophysis and neurohypophysis of the pituitary gland here. Then we're moving into, remember, the neck region. So here we have the trachea, here we have the larynx. So right here we see the thyroid gland. Now right below we're seeing the backside or posterior view of the thyroid gland, and you can pick out parathyroid glands. So remember there's four of those, two on each side. As we move down into the abdominopelvic cavity, here's our kidney, sitting on top is the adrenal gland, and right here we see the pancreas. Over here then would be those gonads. So remember, secondary endocrine structure, and of course a difference for ovaries and the female body, and then testis, we're just seeing one here in the male body. Okay, so let's move on to a little bit more specific structure. So here we see an old friend from AMP1. So of course we should recognize the brain. And I'm going to actually dissect the brain along the longitudinal fissure so that we can open up and see inside. And when we look inside, we're seeing the hypothalamus right in here. We're seeing the infundibulum, which is the stalk that attaches the pituitary gland to the hypothalamus. So the pituitary gland is this like pink little round P-shaped structure. Infundibulum is the stalk, and hypothalamus is this tissue right here where my finger is. At the very back of that, we can see the pineal gland. So remember, there are three endocrine structures in the brain. We have the hypothalamus, we have the pituitary gland, and then here, pineal. And in this view, the pineal's cut in half when I did that dissection. When we look at the pituitary gland a little bit more close up, we can investigate this model here. So one of the things that we can see in this model is the hypothalamus would be up here. Here is the infundibulum or the stalk. We can see that there are capillary beds connecting hypothalamus and pituitary gland. And those capillary beds are connected with what's called a portal vessel. So we can talk about this whole connection of capillaries as the hypophyseal portal system. Remember that hormones are being delivered through the bloodstream. So we're going to have hormones from the hypothalamus being delivered to the pituitary gland in order to control the pituitary gland. And they're proximally, you know, proximal structures. They're close to each other. So it makes sense that you would want to have, you know, a close vascular connection as well, so you can kind of speed up the transmission of those transmission of those hormones. As we look at this model, we see a significant number of neurons from the hypothalamus being delivered to the posterior lobe. So this right here is the posterior lobe of the pituitary, or you can call it the neurohypophysis. Over here, where we see really that hypophyseal portal system, that's how we can detect that this is the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland, or what we can call the adenohypophysis. So here we're seeing hypothalamus, we're seeing infundibulum, we're seeing neurohypophysis, adenohypophysis, and we're seeing the hypophyseal portal system, the connection of those capillary beds. Okay, so next, let's take a look at this model here, because we can see these endocrine structures a little bit better in context with the rest of the anatomy. So we're looking up, of course, we've got the head here and the neck region. Remember, here's your larynx, and right below that would be the thyroid gland, okay? As we move down into the abdominopelvic cavity, what we can do is dissect out liver, dissect out stomach, and then what we're seeing right here is the pancreas. And I can dissect it off. You can see it a little bit more close up there. I can rotate it around so you can see the pancreas there. So what we'll be seeing in the future is that the pancreas really has two jobs. So it has endocrine cells, meaning cells that are making a hormone being released into the bloodstream and circulating the body that way. And then it has what's called exocrine function. And in that case, it's going to be making enzymes, primarily releasing those into pancreatic duct, which goes directly into the small intestine. So we will be revisiting the job of the pancreas when we get into the digestive system. And since I've pulled this part of the model off, I'm able to then see the kidney here. And remember, it's sitting on top of the kidney. We have the adrenal glands. And we're going to be looking at more details of the adrenal glands as part of our diagram work. And in this model, we don't really have any reproductive structures represented, so we're not able to look at the gonads for that. Okay, y'all, I think this is our last model. The rest of our structures that we want to look at will be from the diagram. So here what we're looking at is just a super close-up view of the pancreas, and we'll come back to this when we study pancreas again in the digestive system. So that's what we're seeing right here. This is a piece of small intestine right there. Here's the kidney. So my hands are on the kidney there. And sitting on top is the adrenal gland. This is a different structure we'll be talking about in cardiovascular system and in the lymphatic system. This is the spleen, which you can maybe see right here. You can see my finger there, although you can't see it in the model. Let me rotate it around. So now we're viewing it at the backside. My hand is on the pancreas, and then here is the adrenal gland, there and there. All right. All right, so stay tuned for our next video, which is on diagrams, and we'll talk a little bit more specifically about what hormones are being produced in each one of those glands. So stay tuned, take care of yourself and each other.